lights. Lovely bits of color soaring in the sky. But to the crew of a downed World War II aircraft, a kite could mean the difference between rescue and death. My mother joined the millions of women who worked in defense factories after my father died from a heart attack. She made life rafts for bombers. The radio packed with the raft provided an essential component for rescue. It broadcast an SOS signal to rescuers that could be heard as far as 200 miles away. Bright yellow and curved in at the middle, the survivor held the radio snugly between his knees as he cranked it to send the signal. That curved shape brought about a nickname for the radio. It was affectionately called the Gibson Girl, after a corseted, narrow-waist fashion icon created by Charles Dana Gibson in the 1890s. To send the signal over a long distance, a 200-foot antenna wire needed to be elevated high above the surface of the ocean. A kite and a balloon with a cylinder of gas were provided. It was that kite that intrigued me. I imagined it to be triangular and big, bigger than my house, with bows and stripes like a Gibson Girl fashion model's clothes. Imagine my surprise when, as an adult, I finally saw the kite in the museum. An ordinary-looking yellow box kite. The women in the factory often included personal notes to the flyers that might use their life rafts. Some pressed lipstick kisses on the notes, saying, "Call me when you get home." Others wrote prayers and words of courage and faith. Mom soldered resistors, brightly striped brown cylinders, into each radio. Her job paid piecework, and she could earn a few extra cents for each part she made beyond her quota. We needed the money. So she smuggled resistors out of the factory and got them ready to solder the next day. Evenings, after supper, Mom spent hours twisting resistor wires together with her needle-nosed pliers. The next morning, she smuggled them back into the factory, ready to solder. I was cautioned sternly not to reveal her secret. Now I understand that she was terrified of losing her job. But in my young mind, I believed that if the enemy knew the colors of my mother's resistors, they would have all the information they needed to win the war. Guards frequently checked workers' purses and lunchboxes at the factory gate. She never got caught. Mom never would say where she hid those resistors. But she never got caught.